Have you ever tried managing a project across emails, spreadsheets, and chat threads? It gets messy fast. That's where Jira comes in. It's an AI-powered project management tool that helps you plan, organize, and automate your work all in one place. Hi, I'm Kevin, and today I teamed up with Jira to show you how any team can use it. Not just developers. You'll see how to get started, explore the key features, and use AI to make project management faster and also a whole lot easier. Let's dive in. To get started, head to the link right down below. Once you're on the Jira website, click Get It For Free. One of the really nice things about Jira is that you can use it completely for free for up to 10 users. So, if you want to follow along, go ahead and sign up now. Once you set up your account, Jira will ask you to create a site. A site is your team's shared workspace. It's where all your projects, tasks, and dashboards will live. Right here, Jira automatically suggests a site name based on your email address, but you can change it to anything that fits your team. As an example, I'll set mine to Kevin Cookie Co. for the Kevin Cookie Company, and right down below, let's click on Continue. Next, Jira asks what kind of work your team does. This helps it recommend templates and workflows that fit how your team operates, whether that happens to be software development, maybe marketing, down here we have finance, or maybe even operations. Since I'm planning a cookie box launch campaign, over here I'll choose marketing, but you can pick whatever best matches your team and Jira will automatically set things up for you. I'll click on this. On this screen, Jira asks how your team plans to use it. This helps customize the setup and recommend the right tools and also views. Since I'm planning the cookie box launch campaign, right up on top, I'll choose launch campaigns. Let's also go with manage marketing content. And right down here, we have report on project progress. I think that works well. You could pick up to three options here, but don't worry, your choices won't limit what you can do later. Once you've made all your selections down at the bottom, click on Continue. Now we're setting up our first project, or what's sometimes referred to as a space. This is where your team's work will live. You could think of a space as your team's hub for tracking progress and also staying organized. Now, since I'm planning a cookie box launch campaign, I'll name my project this. Once you've chosen a name, down at the bottom, click on Get Started. Now, Jira asks what type of work you want to track in this space. These are the building blocks of your project. You have things like tasks, requests, campaigns. Now, for this, I'm going to start with task to keep things simple, but you could always add more later on. Down below, let's click on Next. This brings us to the last step in the setup, choosing how you want to track work. By default, Jira gives you three simple stages. We have to do, in progress, and done. I think that's perfect for getting started, so I'll leave it just like this. Of course, you can always add or remove stages later. Down at the bottom, let's now click on Finish, and Jira will create your workspace. And here we are. You're making great progress. This is our new space for the Cookie Box launch campaign. Over on the left-hand side, you'll see the sidebar with our current space selected. This allows you to jump between all of your different spaces. Right up on top, I'll click on this icon to minimize the sidebar. That way, we have a little bit more room to work. Within this view, this is where we'll track everything from start to finish. Across the top, you'll see different views. Like here we have the list view, a board, a calendar, and also a timeline. Now, right now, we're in the list view, which works a lot like a spreadsheet. It's perfect for adding and also organizing tasks. Over on the right-hand side, you'll notice the quick start guide. This gives you tips for getting up and running fast. It's really helpful if you're brand new to Jira, but for now, let's close it out. I'll click on this icon. That way, we can focus on building out our project. Down in the bottom right-hand corner, you could always open it again if you want to review some of the tips. Let's now start by adding a few tasks for the Cookie Box launch campaign. To add a task right over here, let's click on Create, and then we could type in the first task. I'll type in Design Packaging. We want this packaging to look good. Over on the right-hand side, we could click on Create, or what I like doing is simply press the Enter key on your keyboard, and that adds the first task. Let's add a few more. For the second one, we need to write a social media post, then I'll press Enter. And lastly, we also need to review ad copy with legal. This one's extremely important. Then here again, I'll press Enter. And these will be the main things our marketing and design teams need to get started. Of course, you could always come in and add more tasks later. But keeping it simple like this makes it easy to focus on what really matters. For each of these different tasks that we added, you can also set the details related to that task. As an example, you could set a due date. For the design packaging, we need that pretty urgently, so let's set that for next week. Over here, I could also set dates for the other items as well. I'll set a few different dates. To the right of that, we could also set the priority. Design packaging, like I said, is very important, so let's click on that, and let's set it to highest priority. If we scroll over to the right, you'll see that we also have additional fields or columns, and we could enter in different values. If you don't see a column that you need, over on the right-hand side, you can also click on this plus icon, and you could add additional fields to this table. And in fact, you could even add a completely new field down here at the bottom. Let's scroll back over to the left. You can also click into a task to add even more context. Right over here, let's click on the key for design packaging. Here, we can add things like a description. You could add subtasks. You could even link to other work items. And down at the bottom, you could leave comments related to this task. Let's start by adding a quick description. Now, click into this box, and here I could type things in. But to be honest, I've never been that good at writing descriptions. So instead, let's use something called Rovo. This is Jira's built-in AI. Right over here, I'll click on this icon, and this opens up a writing assistant. Down below, I can now type in my prompt. So let's type in, I'm designing packaging for the Kevin Cookie Company cookies. Can you help write a description for this task? Then let's press enter. Right down below, Rovo generates a nice, polished description that I could tweak, or we could just use it as is. Let's go ahead and just use it as it is. Down below, I'll click on insert, and here we have a very nicely written description. Down below, let's click on save. Now that we've added the description, let's go ahead and add a few subtasks. I'll scroll down, and right here, I'll click on subtasks. And we can also use Rovo here to suggest some based on the title and also the description. Right up on top, you'll see it says create suggested work items. And here, let's look at the 6 suggestions. Right down below, we could see some of the suggestions. First off, we need to develop some concepts, select materials, design the visual elements, and then we also have a few other items. Now, I think this looks perfect. Of course, I could even go in and add my own, but for now, I think this works great. Right down below, let's click on create all. Right up above, you can see all of our different subtasks. And here too, just like we saw with tasks, you could also adjust the various fields or details related to those subtasks. Over on the right-hand side, we also have all of the high-level task details. And just like we saw in the list view, you can also completely customize this. Right up on top, I'll click on the settings gear, and here you can modify all of the different fields. I'm now all done configuring this task. So in the top right-hand corner, let's go back to the main list view. I'll click on this X icon. Back within the main list view, right over here, I see the design packaging task, and over on the left-hand side, we see this caret icon. I can expand the task, and here we see all of the associated subtasks all neatly organized. Let's go ahead and collapse it. We have a few different tasks coming together here, but I really just want to see the highest priority tasks. Right about top, similar to a spreadsheet, you can filter the view. Now click on this dropdown, and you could filter by just about anything. Assigned to, what's due this week, or anything that's been completed. If I scroll down a little bit more, here you can see that we could also filter by the priority. And again, I just want to see the highest priority tasks. I'll click on this, and that filters the view. There's that design packaging. It's very high priority. Right up on top, I could also turn off this filter. When I click on this, here we could clear the filter, and now I see all the different tasks again. Similar to a spreadsheet, you could also sort by all of these different column headers. Currently, I could see all the oldest tasks to the newest tasks, but over here, if I click on this icon, that switches the order, and here I see the newest to the oldest. And again, I could click on that again, and that changes the sorting. Along with filtering and sorting, I could also adjust this view. Now, I actually prefer to see the priority ahead of the due date. So over here, I could press and hold on this column and drag it over, and here I could place it before the due date. That way, I can keep an eye on what matters the most to me. I honestly feel so much better now that we're tracking these tasks and they're not just floating around in my mind. So far, we've been looking at everything in the list view, which is great for organizing tasks like you would in a spreadsheet. But one of the best things about Jira is that you can switch between different views depending on how your team likes to work. Let's now shift to the board view. Right up on top, I'll click on board. This gives us a Kanban-style board where we can move the different tasks through all the different stages. There's that design packaging task, and it's high priority. Now, I've started putting in a description, and I also thought about some of the subtasks. So I personally think that qualifies as in progress. So I could simply press and hold on this task, and here I could drag it over to in progress. And look at that, starting to get things done. Up on top, we can also shift into the calendar view. That way we could see all the different upcoming tasks by date. Right over here, we could visualize all of that on a calendar. This is perfect for keeping track of deadlines. And up on top, there's also a timeline view. This gives a Gantt chart style layout that's really great for visualizing how different tasks overlap and also depend on one another. We've got a great project plan coming together, but I can't do all this work on my own. So let's get some reinforcements by inviting some teammates. To add people, in the top right-hand corner, click on the settings gear, and then at the bottom of this menu, click into user management. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on invite users, and at the very top, you can simply type in their email address. Here, I'll type in Nestor's email address, insert a comma, and let's also enter in Patty's email address. Now, down at the bottom, I'll click on Send Invite. Now that I've added a few teammates, I can now assign tasks to them. Let's go back to the Jira list view. Up on top, I'll switch back to my other tab. Right here, let's go back to the list view. I think Nestor would really handle this task well. He has a really good relationship with the legal team. Over here, I'll click on Assignee, and here I see the two people that I just added. I'll select Nestor right there. Now, Nestor tends to work really fast, so let's have a quick look at the details of this task. I'll click into it. Within the task, down at the bottom, I can see all of the activity, and it looks like Nestor really does work fast. He already has a question for me. Can you confirm if legal needs to review both the ad copy and the social post, or just the ad copy? Well, we just need the ad copy reviewed. So right down below, I'll click on reply, and here it says at Nestor, and let me type in my message, just the ad copy, thanks. Right down below, I'll click on save, and there, that'll send the response to Nestor. In the top right hand corner, let's now close out of this view. I'll click on the X right up here. Back within the list view, here I can see all of the latest activity related to this task, and here I see that there are two comments related to this task. Now that our campaign is underway, other teams are starting to send in marketing requests. You could think of things like new graphics or product photos. Instead of managing all of that through email, I can create a simple form that sends everything straight into Jira. Let's click on Forms right up on top, and then right down below, let's click on Create Form. I'll base this on a task since each request will become its own task. Let's click here. At the top, let's give this form a name. I'll highlight this and let's call it the Marketing Content Request Form. Down below, I can also add various fields. We have a summary, description, attachment. Those all look good, but I'd also like to include a due date. That way I know when we have to get this work done. Over here, I could drag this field and put it right there on my form. That's perfect. Now, when someone fills this out, Jira will automatically create a new task directly within our space. That'll make things a lot easier. Now, up on top, I can share this form with others. That way they can start filling it out. And right over here, we can also preview what the form looks like in a new tab. Let's go ahead and preview it to see what it looks like. And here we can see a preview of what this form looks like. Let's try filling it out. Right up on top, I'll type in a summary of a new work item that I have. And down below, I could also type in a description for it. Now I could also add an attachment and let's select a due date. I'll place it for the 21st. Down below, let's submit this. Now that we've submitted the form, let's go back to the main list view. And look at that. We now have a new task added to the bottom of this list. And here's another really neat thing. If I scroll over in this table, you'll notice that it also added two labels or tags, letting us know where this item came from. That way we could easily filter or sort all the requests created this way. Now, this is such a cool way to keep everything organized and to intake additional information. Oh, looks like I just received an email from my manager. Hope you're doing well. I wanted to check in on the cookie box launch campaign and see how things are progressing. And looks like she wants an update. You know, sometimes it feels like it's more work just to get work done. Now, I could write her response, but let's actually see if maybe Jira can just help me with this. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on the Ask Rovo. Again, this is Jira's AI assistant. Down below, it says, how can I help you? Well, I could certainly use some help. Let's type in a prompt. Write a quick project update on the cookie box launch campaign. We've added all of these details into Jira. Let's see if it could come up with a quick summary that I could send back to my manager. Over here, let's send it. Rovo now looks at all the tasks in the project. what's been done, what's in progress, and what's coming up. And over here, it generates a short summary that I can now share with my manager. And here it provides the update on the latest activity between me and Nestor. That's pretty helpful. Now, beyond writing updates or descriptions, Rovo can do so much more. In fact, in a moment, we'll automate some repetitive tasks just by using plain language. And beyond that, Jira includes something called Rovo Skills. Now, you might be wondering, what is that? Well, these are specialized AI helpers trained for specific tasks. As an example, analyzing project themes, or maybe checking content that you've created against brand guidelines. Kind of like having dedicated mini assistants built right into your workspace. I just noticed that a lot of these different tasks in the list view don't have an owner. And you know what that means, if there's no owner, it's not getting done. Now, of course, I could click through and I could assign someone manually, but we could also automate this. We could set up a simple rule so every time a new task is created, like say, for example, someone fills out our marketing request form, Jira can automatically assign it to me. To set up an automation, right up on top, let's click on this icon. Right down below, let's click on Explore Templates. Let's try using Rovo to build this automation. Right over here, I could tell Rovo what I'm trying to automate. When a new task is created, assign it to me, Kevin Stratvert, and notify me on Slack. Let's preview the rule. And look at that, Rovo builds the automation automatically. Right up on top, we have the trigger. A new work item is created, and then there are two different actions. It assigns the work item to me, and it also sends me a Slack notification to let me know that there's now a new work item. Here, I could review all the details, make any quick edits, and if I'm satisfied with everything, right up on top, I can now turn on the rule. And there I could see that the new rule has been turned on. Now, anytime someone creates a new task, even from our form, Jira will assign it to me automatically and send me a Slack notification. That way, I can stay on top of any new requests right away. Now that we've added tasks, forms, and automation, let's look at how we can track progress and connect Jira with the other tools we use. To track the overall progress of our project, right up on top, let's switch into the summary view. And here we get a quick snapshot of how things are going. Right up on top, I can see a status overview. We have 10 total items and one is in progress. We're lagging a little bit. We'll have to get more of these items in progress. Right over here, I can see all of the recent activity. I can see a breakdown of all of the different priorities, the types of work, and I can also see how many different items are assigned to members on the team. It looks like Nestor is currently carrying all the load. I guess I'll probably have to pick something up. This is a great way to get a quick read on how things are going. In the top left-hand corner, let's now open up the sidebar, and then right down at the bottom, let's click on More. Then let's shift into the apps view. Here, Jira integrates with over 3,000 different apps. That way, if your team works in tools like Slack, Teams, or Power BI, you can connect all of them here. What that means is that updates, analytics, and reports can flow automatically between Jira and all the other tools that you already use. There's one final thing I want to do before we wrap up. In the top left-hand corner, let's open up the sidebar again, and let's go back to the cookie box launch campaign space. It really feels like something's missing here. I think we could personalize this a little bit more. Right up on top, let's click on the three-dot menu for more actions. And this is one of my favorites. Right down here, we have the option to set a space background. Let's click on that, and here we see all these different photos that we could choose from. We have different colors, and you can even upload custom images. But let's try searching to see if maybe they have an image of some cookies. And they do. Of course they do. Then I think I like this one. I'll select that. Then let's close out of this view right here and check out this space. This is looking really nice now. It's a small touch, but it makes the workspace feel a lot more personal and personally, I think fun. And that's a quick look at how you could use Jira for project management. What's great about Jira is that it brings all your teams together. Marketing, operations, design, even legal, all in one place. Now, many other tools handle just one side of project management, but Jira scales across the entire organization, and it even adds built-in AI to keep everything connected. Again, you could try Jira for free, and the link is right down below. And stay tuned. Let's see how that cookie box launch campaign turns out.